Hello children, I am your Padma teacher. In my previous video of Math Magic channel, I have explained you the MCQs, 1 mark questions, 2 marks activities and questions of arithmetic progressions from algebra. In today's video, I am going to explain you the 3 marks activities of the same chapter, arithmetic progressions from the question bank. Before starting, I request all of you to like, subscribe to our Math Magic channel and press the bell also so that you can watch all the videos. Now, let's move to the question bank, arithmetic progressions, 3 marks activities. Look at the question. Question for 3 marks, A. In third question A, you will be asked these activities. A. Complete the following activity. First question, how many 2-digit numbers are divisible by 5? Even the question is in a single line, there are different conditions in the question, children. How many you have to find out? There are the conditions. 2-digit numbers divisible by 5. Divisible by 5 means those numbers should be divisible by 5. That means if you divide those numbers by 5, the remainder must be 0. That means in simple way, you can understand those numbers are multiples of 5. Those are the multiples of 5. That means 5, 10, 15, etc. These are the multiples. But one more condition is given. What is the other condition? 2-digit number. If you take 5, it will not satisfy that condition. So you have to start from 1. Sorry, from 10. So the multiples of 5 are the numbers which are divisible by 5. 2-digit numbers which are divisible by 5 will be 10, 15, 20, etc. Up to 95 you have to take. Even 100 is a multiple of 5. That 100 has 3 digits. So you should not take 100. So starting from 10 to 95. 10, 15, 20, etc. 95 you have to take. Look at the activity. 2-digit numbers divisible by 5 are 10, 15, 20, etc. 95. I am explaining why all these lines I am explaining because these questions may be asked in 3 marks questions also, children. Even it is given in activity now, answer is ready, only you have to fill the boxes. I am explaining everything because the same type of questions you may get in 3 marks, there you can write the answer on your own. Now in the activity, first line, 2-digit numbers divisible by 5 are 10, 15, 20, etc. 95. Up to there you understood. Here, D is equal to 5. That means the common difference. That is T2 minus T1, 15 minus 10. The D is equal to 5. Therefore, this sequence is an AP because here every number is added, the common difference 5. And you will get the next number. That means the difference is common. Common difference is 5. So it is an AP. Here, A is equal to 10. First number is 10. T1 is 10. D is equal to 5. Tn is equal to 95. You should find n. How many numbers you have to find out. So the last term is 95. That is Tn is 95. So you write the formula for Tn. Tn is equal to A plus n minus 1. Into D. You have to write D there in the box. The bracket they have given outside the box. Actually the bracket must be before D, children. In the box you have to put D. Now Tn. In the place of Tn, substitute 95. Because Tn is 95. Write 95 in the second box is equal to A plus n minus 1 into D. Instead of A, 10 is given plus n minus 1 multiplied by instead of D, 5 is substituted. Now in the next step, right hand side 10 is there. On the right hand side 10 is there. That will be brought to left hand side. Then 95 minus 10 is equal to 85. So you should write 85 in the box. For explanation I gave on the left hand side 95 minus 10 is equal to 85. 95 minus 10 is 85. So you write 85 there. All the steps will not be given in activities, children. As I said earlier, you have to solve them somewhere and you have to write the, you have to keep on writing the answers. So 85 is equal to n minus 1 multiplied by 5. In the next step, in the box, you have to write only the answer directly. What is the answer? What would be the answer? 85 divided by 5. from the right hand side, 5 comes to right hand side and it will divide 85. 85 divided by 5 is equal to 17. So you must write 17 there in the box. 17 is equal to n minus 1. In the next step, from the right hand side, minus 1 comes to the left hand side and it will be added to 17. So 17 plus 1 is 18. So finally you have, therefore, n is equal to 18. So write 18 in the box. There are, next statement answer, there are 18 two digit numbers divisible by 5. So in the first box D, second box 95, third box 85, fourth box 17, fifth box 18, sixth box is also 18. Now let's move to question number 2, activity number 2. Second activity, Kalpana saves some amount every month. In first 3 months, she saves 100 rupees, 150 rupees and 200 rupees respectively. In how many months will she save 1200 rupees? So in this question, what do you understand? Kalpana saves the money. She saves 100 rupees in the first month, in the second month 150 rupees and in the third month 200 rupees. That means every month she is increasing 50 rupees. So these numbers, these amounts of money which she is saving is an AP. In the AP, they are telling in after some months, how many months they are asking, you have to tell the number of months. After some months, she will save 1200 rupees. That means TN is given 1200, A is 100 rupees because she started with 100 rupees in the first month. That means T1 is 100. Common difference D is 150 minus 100, that is 50. That means how much she is increasing? You have to think she is increasing 50 rupees every month. So that is D. A is 100, D is 50, TN is 1200. She is saving 1200 rupees after some months. So 1200 will be taken as TN. Then you have to find N. Like in the previous question, same way you substitute the values in the formula and you will simplify. So look at the answer activity. Kalpana's monthly saving is 100 rupees, 150 rupees, 200 rupees, etc. 1200 rupees. At the end, in 1 month, she is paying 1200 rupees. Here, D is equal to 50. Therefore, this sequence is NAP. Every month, she is increasing a fixed amount, 50 rupees. So it is NAP. Now, coming to if it is NAP, the first term A is equal to 100. The first term A is 100. D is equal to 50. Actually, A is equal to 10 only it is printed there, children. That is why I have written one more zero there. A should be 100. That is a printing mistake. D is equal to 50. TN is equal to 1200. N is equal to how much? You have to find the value of N. So, write the formula for TN. TN is equal to A plus N minus 1. Multiplied by D. D is missing there. So put D in the second box. Next, in the place of TN, substitute 1200. 1200 is equal to 100 plus N minus 1 multiplied by 50. All these numbers, they only have substituted. In the place of A, 100. In the place of D, 50 is given. In the next step, 100 from the right hand side comes to left hand side, then it becomes 1200 minus 100, answer is 1100. I gave in green color, the explanation is there on the left hand side. So you can write 1100 in that box. The fourth box, you have to write 1100. In the fourth box, put 1100. 1100 by 50 is equal to n minus 1. At the time, they have done two operations there. Look at the above step. 100 is brought to left hand side, so it is subtracting. It is subtracted from 1200. 1200 minus 100 becomes 1100. 1100. And then what else is remaining on the right hand side? N minus 1 multiplied by 50 is there. That 50 is also brought to left hand side. Because it is multiplying on the right hand side, it comes to divide on the left hand side. So 1100 upon 50 is equal to N minus 1. That step also is given on the left hand side in the explanation with green color. You can see 1100 upon 50. If you simplify that, you get the answer 22 there. 1100 divided by 50, answer is 22. That means what do you get? 22 is equal to n minus 1. So that minus 1 comes to left hand side again. N will be 22 plus 1. Answer will be 23. All these calculations if you don't do, you cannot fill anything in the boxes, children. So even these are activities you should keep on calculating, working you should do. Then only you will get the answers. So N is equal to 23. Finally you got. So last box, therefore, she saves 1200 rupees in 23 months. That means after 23 months, she started from 100, 100, 150, 200, 250, 300 like that. After 23 months, she will reach to 1200 rupees and in the 23rd month, she will save 1200 rupees. So first box is 1200, second box is D, third box is 1200, fourth box is 1100. Fifth box is 23 and sixth box is also 23. Now let's see the activity number 3, third activity. Determine the sum of the first 100 terms of the given AP 12, 14, 16, 18, 20, etc. Here A is equal to T1, that is 12. D is equal to T2 minus T1, that is 14 minus 12. Answer is you should keep these things in your mind. So activity, when you fill here, they are asking to find the sum of first 100 terms. That means S 100 you have to find out. That means you should know the formula for SN. Now write these things. A is equal to 12. It is already given. D is equal to 2 because we have calculated just now. 14 minus 12 is 2. D is equal to 2. You have to write in the box. N is equal to 100. Yes, 100 is equal to how much? To find out that, you should observe the given things. Here what are given? A is given and D is also given. N is 100. A, D, N are given. So you should take the formula which contains A, N and D. So our formula will be SN is equal to N upon 2 multiplied by 2A plus N minus 1 into D. So in the box you have to fill 2A. In the second box, you have to fill 2A. Actually, here also one printing mistake is there, children. After the box, there should be plus. But plus is missing. So I have given for your convenience plus. Also, I gave there 2A plus N minus 1 multiplied by D. Now, coming to S 100. Because we should find the 100 sum of the 100 terms. So, S 100 is equal to, instead of N, substitute 100. 100 upon 2 multiplied by, in the bracket, 24, they have written directly. That means 2A, 2 12s are 24. If you keep on observing all the steps, how this answer has come, you will automatically fill the boxes, children. Directly from one box to other box, if you go on jumping and going, you cannot write the answers properly. You should not jump like that. You have to see all the steps and answers also you should go through. How this answer has come like that, how this number is written here, like that you should think and you have to see. Now, S 100 is equal to 100 by 2. That is third box line I am reading now. 100 by 2. In the bracket you have 24 plus N is 100. 100 minus 1 multiplied by D. Actually, D should be substituted there. D value is 2. So, if you substitute in the next step, what happens? Let us see. 100 by 2 is clear answer 50. In the bracket, 24 will come as it is. 100 minus 1 is 99. 99 multiplied by D value is 2. You have to multiply 99 and 2. 99 2s are 198. So in the box, in the third box, you have 198. 50 multiplied by 24 plus 198. Now after adding 24 and 198, you get 222. So 50 multiplied by 222 will come in the fifth box. 50 multiplied by 222. If you multiply and find out the product, calculate, you get the answer 11,100. 11,100 is the sum of the first 100 terms in the given AP. So first box is D is equal to 2. Second box is 2A plus. Third box is 100, fourth box is 198, fifth box is 50 multiplied by 222, last box is 11,100. Next, fourth activity. Look at the activity. Find the sum of natural numbers between 1 to 140 which are divisible by 4. Again, two conditions are there. What are they? The natural numbers between 1 and 140 which are divisible by 4. That means the multiples of 4. Simply, in simple ways, you can take 4 table answers. They are 4, 8, 12, 16, 20, 24, etc. Like that. But up to 20 only we know the table, but you have to just find out which is divisible by 4. But one small thing you must remember here while finding out these numbers, the natural numbers between is given, between 1 to 140. Between means you should not take 1 and 140. You should not take either 1 or 140. Sometimes they give the natural numbers from 1 to 140. From 1 to 140 means you should take both the ends if needed, depending on the second condition. Here 1 and 140 you should leave, and you have to take the numbers which are in the middle, in between of 1 and 140. So 4 is the first multiple. 4 ones are 4, so starting from 4, 4 is the first multiple. And before 140 you have 136. Even 140 is also a multiple of 4. You should not take that. Again, I'm telling, because this number must be between 1 and 140. So these numbers are 4, 8, 12, 16, etc. 136. Now coming to here, D is equal to 4. Because these are the multiples of 4. Every number, if you add the common difference, you will get the next number. So D is equal to 4. Therefore, this sequence is an AP. Now, A is equal to 4. First number is 4. So, A is equal to 4. And common difference is also 4. So, D is equal to 4. Tn is equal to 136. Tn is equal to 136. You have to find the value of Sn. Now, look at the activity. Actual activity starts here. Tn is equal to A plus n minus 1 multiplied by d. That is the standard formula for Tn. Formula is given. Now substitute the values. Tn value is 136. So put 136 in the first box. Is equal to A value is 4, n minus 1 multiplied by the value of d is also 4. So 136 is equal to 4 plus n minus 1 multiplied by 4. In the next step, what do you get on the left hand side? It is written 132. But how do you get that 132? Because in the above step, 4 plus is there. That 4 should be brought to left hand side. On the explanation part, I gave you 136 minus 4 is equal to 132. So 132 is equal to n minus 1 multiplied by 4. In the next step, that 4 from right hand side, which is multiplying n minus 1, will come to left hand side. 132 upon 4. You get the answer 33. So 33 is equal to n minus 1. Actually, all these steps are missing. You have to write somewhere in an order so that you will get what is missing, what should be filled in the box like that. 33 is equal to n minus 1. So n is equal to 33 plus 1. So 34. You get the value of n as 34. So you have to fill 34 there. Actually, there two steps are missing in between. Those two steps, if you write properly, you get the value, exact value, what should be filled in the box. Now first box is 136, second box is 132, third box is 34. N is equal to 34. That means you understood that there are 34 terms. You have to find Sn. Sn, sum of all those terms, no? They have asked, that means Sn you have to find. But to find the value of Sn, there are two formulas as we have seen earlier. Here A is given 4 and Tn is given 136. So you can use the formula Sn is equal to n upon 2 multiplied by A plus Tn. Here also again mistake is there, printing mistake. They have given plus there. It should not be plus, children. It should be multiplication. N upon 2 multiplied by A plus Tn. Actually, A means T1 only. We have in our textbook formula N upon 2 multiplied by T1 plus Tn is there. But Tn means A only. So, substitute now. N upon 2 means 34 upon 2. Directly answer 17 is written there. Is equal to T1 plus Tn. So, T1 is 4. Tn is 136. If you add 4 plus 136, you get the answer 140. So 140 is written in that box, fourth box. On the right hand side, I gave you 4 plus 136 is equal to 140. Now, clear multiplication, direct multiplication, 17 into 140, you multiply somewhere and write the answer there. You get the answer 2380. Write the answer in statement form. Therefore, the sum of natural numbers between 1 to 140, which are divisible by 4, is 2380. Next activity number 5. Decide whether 301 is a term of given sequence 5, 11, 17 and 23. This is a new type question, children. Till now we have not done this type of question anywhere, either in 1 marks or 2 marks. We have not done. So look at the question. What is given? Decide whether 301 is a term of the given sequence 5, 11, 17, 23, etc. For that, what do they give? Here D is equal to, what is D? You have to find out. There actually, you have to write T2 minus T1 is equal to 11 minus 5. The answer is 6. In the next box, you can write 6, or in the first box also, you can fill 6 directly. But, sorry children, there was a little disturbance. Now let's come to this again. D is equal to T2 minus T1 is equal to 11 minus 5. In the first box, what I was telling, you can write directly 6 or you can write the formula like this as I gave. Now, next line, A is equal to 5. According to our statements, A is equal to 5. If you see the AP, first term is 5, A is equal to 5. D is equal to 6, which we found in the top box. D is equal to 6. Let nth term of this AP be 301. As I said, this is a new type question, 301. You have to take it as the nth term. That means Tn. You can take Tn. Then Tn is equal to a plus n minus 1 multiplied by d. Then substitute the values. Tn is equal to 301 is equal to 5 plus n minus 1 into the box is given. There again you substitute 6. Next, 301 is equal to, it becomes 6n minus 1. How it becomes? It is given on the right hand side. You look at that green part. 5 plus n minus 1 multiplied by 6, I am removing the bracket there. 5 plus 6n minus 6. 5 minus 6 becomes minus 1, so the answer is 6n minus 1. That is there, which is given here on the statements. 301 is equal to 6n minus 1. Next step, you have like this. Minus 1 comes to left hand side, then it becomes 302. 302 is equal to 6n. So n is equal to 302 divided by 6. If you simplify that, you get the answer 51 upon 3. Here, the main thing comes. 51 upon 3. If you count the numbers, first term, second term, third term, fourth term, like that, you will have either fourth term, fifth term, 100th term, 200th term, 98th term, like that, you have that number. But here, 51 by 3 is there. So you cannot say any number as a 51 by 3rd term, like that you cannot read. 51 by 3rd term, like that you will not have. You will have either 50th term or 51st term you will have. That means, but n is not a positive integer. That means it should be positive integer. But then n is here 51 by 3 means, which is a positive rational number. We should have only integer, not the rational numbers. So you cannot consider this term as a part of this AP. Therefore, 301 is not the term of the given sequence 5, 11, 17, 23. Not will come in the last box. So first box, you can write 6 or you can write the formula as I gave. And second box, 6. Third box, D. Fourth box, 6. Fifth box, 50. 1 by 3. And last box, not. These 5 activities are given for 3 marks in the question bank, children. I am sorry, actually I wanted to take less time, around 20 minutes, but today it is exceeded for 5 minutes because these are 3 marks activities and they needed little more explanation. So I have taken just 5 minutes extra and I hope you have understood these questions. If you like these videos, please like, subscribe and share our Math Magics channel to all of your 10th standard friends, so that they also get the answers of board question bank. Thank you, children.